Welcome to a second lesson on linear growth. In this lesson, we will express linear growth in recursive form as well as explicit form, but in this lesson, we won't be given d, the common difference, or the slope. We'll have to find it. So for review, if a quantity starts at size p sub 0 and grows by d every time period, then the quantity after n time periods can be determined using either of the two relations expressed here. In recursive form, p sub n is equal to p sub n minus 1 plus d, where p sub n is the population 1 unit of time before p sub n. The explicit form would be p sub n equals p sub 0 plus d times n. Now the explicit form here is the same as the slope-intercept form of a line, or the form y equals mx plus b, where p sub 0 would be b, the y-intercept, d, the common difference would be the same as the slope m, and p sub n is the same as the output or the y value. So again, in this equation, d represents the common difference, the amount the population changes each time n increases by 1. So the common difference d, which again is the same as the slope, would be equal to the change in the function output divided by the change in the function input. Or if we were given 2 points, you may remember we can find the slope by determining the change in y divided by the change of x. Let's take a look at an example. The javelina population of a local desert park was estimated at 200 in the year 2004. In 2012, the population was estimated to be 376. One, assuming linear growth, we want to find a recursive and explicit equation for the growth. Two, we want to predict the javelina population in 2016. And then three, predict when the population will reach 500. Notice for both the recursive and explicit formulas, we'll have to find the common difference d, which should also be the slope of the line. So let's begin by doing that. Remember, d is going to be equal to the change in the output, or in this case, the change in the population, divided by the change in the input, which in this case would be the change in the years. So again, d, the common difference in this case, is going to be equal to the change in the population divided by the change in the years. Well, the change in the population would be 376 minus 200. And the change in the years would be 2012 minus 2004. So we'd have 176 divided by 8, which is equal to 22. And because the common difference is positive, this indicates the population is increasing 22 javelina per year. And because we're assuming linear growth, this is the constant rate of change each year. There's one more thing to mention here. P sub 0 is the starting population, or the population when n equals 0, which means n equals 0 represents the year 2004. So we can say n equals the number of years after 2004. Before we find the recursive and explicit equations to model this growth, let's take a look at this graphically. Knowing the population was 200 in 2004, that would be the point 0, 200, where the first coordinate is n, and the second coordinate is p sub n. Remember, n is the number of years after 2004, and therefore n is 0 for the year 2004. The second point in 2012, when the population is 376, would be 8, 376. Notice n is 8 here because 2012 is 8 years after 2004. Another way to find n is to take 2012 and subtract 2004. So if we plot these 2 points on the coordinate plane, here's 0, 200, and here's 8, 376. Because we're assuming linear growth, when we find the equations in both recursive and explicit form, both formulas would give us points on this line. So now let's go back and find the recursive and explicit equations. In recursive form, P sub n, where the population n years after 2004 would be equal to P sub n minus 1, the population 1 year before P sub n, plus the common difference, which is 22. This would be the recursive formula for our linear growth. And now for the explicit equation, we have P sub n equals P sub 0 plus d times n, which would give us P sub n equals P sub 0 represents the starting population, or the population in 2004, which is 200. So we have 200 plus the common difference times n, so plus 22n. This would be the explicit form for our linear growth. Now we want to predict the javelina population in 2016. To do this, we could use either formula, but to use the recursive formula, we'd have to calculate the population for each year from 2004 to 2016, which would be a lot of work. But using our explicit formula, we can just substitute the value of n for the year 2016. Therefore, we'll use the explicit equation to answer this question. So again, we know that P sub n equals 200 plus 22n, but we still have to determine the value of n, where again, n is a number of years after 2004. So if we're trying to make a prediction for the year 2016, n is equal to 2016 minus 2004, which would be 12. 2016 is 12 years after 2004. So the population after 12 years, or P sub 12, is equal to 200 plus 22 times 12, which would be 200 plus 264. The total would be 464. So in 2016, the predicted population is 464 javelina. Now for part three, we want to predict when the population will reach 500. So again, we'll use the explicit equation. We'll substitute 500 for P sub n and solve for n. So we want to solve the equation 500 equals 200 plus 22n. We'll subtract 200 on both sides. That would give us 300 equals 22n. Divide both sides by 22. 300 divided by 22 is approximately 13.64. Remember, n is a number of years after 2004, so 2004 plus 13.64 would be 2017.64. Rounding to the nearest year, we can say the population will reach 500 in 2018. I hope you found this helpful.